author and intimacy expert Laura M. Brotherson, host of the Marital Intimacy Show, educates and inspires women to create a mutually fulfilling, intimate, and passionate marital relationship, emotionally, spiritually, and sexually.
Hi there. Welcome to the Marital Intimacy Show, available at themaritalintimacyshow.com. My name is Laura Brotherson. Thanks for tuning in today. Well, we get to talk about sex and intimacy today. How fun is that? The title of this episode, number 51, is The Agony and the Ecstasy of Oneness in Marriage. So, let's get started. Okay, I wanted to share another little segment from a fun interview I did with the gals at Healthy, Wealthy, and Wow Radio. And in this segment, we discuss some of the struggles or challenges of oneness, as well as the exquisite joy and the possibilities that are available to a husband and wife, if they will work at it. So, here we go.
Here's the problem, Laura.
Okay.
It's so easy for us to figure out. It's like, well, why wouldn't they get it?
Yeah.
You know?
But that's because we think like a woman.
Exactly.
Until we learn to think like a man, you know, a lot of people will come to me and say, well, if my husband would just da-da-da. And I just sometimes get a chance to sort of say, but you're thinking like a woman.
Yeah.
You need to think like a man if you want to create this exquisite oneness that's possible in marriage. And this is not just physical. This is physical, emotional, and spiritual. And that's why oneness is our ultimate goal of marriage, because it encompasses everything. And then you have something that is so rich and so much more satisfying that it's probably something that currently only exists in most of our dreams. But it can actually become a reality, and that's my point.
She looks really happy, so I know it works.
And people always say, why does your husband smile so much?
Well, there's a couple in here that I would really like to talk about,
okay.
But the one I think that interests me the most is the one that says, the guy needs sex to feel love, and the woman
yes.
needs love to desire sex.
Yes. There is this.
Well, read that again. I got to hear that again.
The guy needs sex to feel love, and the woman needs love to desire sex.
Oh.
Yes. So think about that. That is and here's the big picture. I believe that the purpose of marriage is to help a husband and wife become whole and become one, okay? So if you look at that one sexual difference right there, you can see that a woman gets to sex in a very different way than a man gets to love. And it's kind of these opposite directions. If you see in the book, I've actually got a cycle there. Mm-hmm. And so what you have to understand is, okay, your husband almost needs that physical intimacy before he can feel that emotional and spiritual intimacy that we want so desperately for them to feel. Whereas we realize, okay, if we know that we have to go through the emotional intimacy and the spiritual intimacy connected to get to the physical intimacy, then we can just look at that and go, okay, this is just kind of how we are. Let's work it to make it work. Instead of, ugh, all he ever wants is, or she's, ugh, you know, we don't have to be so frustrated with our differences.
You know, and everything you're saying, it sounds like that's another core piece of what you're writing about, is to eliminate that frustration.
Yes.
And make sure both parties are satisfied.
Exactly. That, you know, and I talk about in the introduction that my whole thing is for a mutually fulfilling relationship. And unfortunately, there's a lot of one or the other of the spouses generally tends to be a wife that thinks, you know, 2 minutes, let's be done, I want to go to bed. And they don't really even know that they have a need for it. Because this is what's interesting. As women mature, they develop more understanding and more need for the sexual intimacy. As men mature and get past just that initial rush, they are then able to get into that emotional and spiritual intimacy, which is odd, as you can kind of just see how that brings you together into this very wonderful oneness. And so I've learned that there's a purpose for the struggles that we have and the differences that we have. And it's really quite exciting if you'll start to work at it and make it come together.
Wow. We have to take just a short commercial break, but hang in there. We will be back. And Laura's got more. This is absolutely fascinating. The book, of course, is called And They Were Not Ashamed, Strengthening Marriage Through Sexual Fulfillment. I think what you're talking to, you know, affects all of us women. And like you had said in the beginning of the interview, a lot of us just either we've suppressed it and said, I'm okay with how things are now, or have accepted. But to me, you're also saying, you know, it could be even better. Just think, you know, if you can implement a few things of changing some mindsets, being open enough to talk about some stuff, that the fulfillment is there for both parties and that oneness in marriage.
This is a big motivator for me, is understanding that things can be so much better. I feel that so many of us are missing out on so much of the exquisite potential of marriage, that wonderful intimate, you know, this is a human need. Intimacy, emotionally, physically, spiritually, is a human need. And it's like we just kind of subsist with this little low level of what's available. And I know that there's more out there for every one of us, and I want to help people to find that.
Okay, now we were talking before the break, and Kay's going to give us another one, some of the between husband and wives. Men think one way, women think another way. Mm-hmm. So what were some of the other ones?
Well,
Chapter 5, I've lost
my place in the book. I was reading ahead. And while I'm finding my place, maybe she can address this thing that I was wondering about. It says, asking for what you want and need. Ooh. Why is it so hard for women, and I guess men too, to be specific and talk about that with each other?
Well, you've got two parts. Number one, we're talking about a taboo subject that's very delicate and very sensitive. And it's, you know, to actually say, oh, honey, don't do that, or well, you do this instead. That's difficult for us. That's really difficult because of the subject matter. But secondly, almost even more so, is that it's almost not okay to have needs and to have them met. It's kind of moves you into this category of selfishness. And so we've been conditioned that selfishness is bad, you know, to want your own thing, you know, to have a need and to want it to be fulfilled is almost kind of negative. But this is something that's kind of against what we normally think, especially if you're talking about intimacy. A woman especially has got to learn to be self-focused, or she will have a difficult time experiencing the intimacy that's available for her there.
Well, there you have it. I hope this gives you something to think about and provides some suggestions for the challenges that couples inevitably face in the intimate relationship of marriage. This has been episode number 51, The Agony and the Ecstasy of Oneness in Marriage, on The Marital Intimacy Show with Laura M. Brotherson. Thanks for tuning in today. We'll be back next week with more great insights for strengthening your marriage. Be sure to click the like button on the homepage of this episode to share these insights with others. And check out our website, strengtheningmarriage.com, to learn more about strengthening your marriage intimately. We hope you'll connect up with us on Facebook on the Marital Intimacy Show page, where it's just easy to interact and share insights every day. Until next time, this is Laura Brotherson with the Marital Intimacy Show. Have a great day, and make yours a great marriage.